The Royal Logistic Corps trainees are facing a feared three-day survival course in Hampshire. On exercise Rolling Rock, they must sleep in the open and find their own food. If they don't, they'll starve. Once fully fledged soldiers, their job will be to provide transport and supplies to Britain's frontline forces.
Right, this is what's happened. You're all members of a relief squadron moving up by helicopter, okay? The helicopter has crash-landed on the field over there, and you've managed to get out of the helicopter with the equipment you've got on you now.
You've got no food, not a sleeping bag, no real mat, and you've just got to survive with what you've got.
No toothbrush.
No wash kit.
No shaving kit. No deodorant. No hair gel.
No hair blush.
Oh, no!
300 miles north in Catterick, the trainee guardsmen of 22 Platoon are beginning a grueling 16-week course.
You've now had...
They're training for a major exercise in the field.
An extra 4 minutes. Get out on the grass area.
No, can't find your fucking helmet.
Get outside on the grass area, just out the back.
18-year-old Peter Elliott has left behind a troubled childhood. He lost his mother at 14 and has found a new home in the army.
Could you go out and kill somebody with a baddie?
Aye, easy. I think I could. There's a lot of people out there I would love to kill.
Come on, get out!
I've got to go, Tim.
Nobody got the water bowls in? Hey, you are not going anywhere. If you haven't got your water bottle, you haven't got your water bottle. Who hasn't got the water bottle?
Andy Leavesley is the platoon sergeant, responsible for the discipline of the guards.
Drop the pressure position. Now!
Because of a mistake by a few, the whole platoon is punished.
One for every man who's not got his water bottle. Here we go. Down.
In the army, teamwork is everything.
Down. Up. Down. Up. Down. Up. Down.
You have to work as a team. That's the worst thing you can do is be jack on someone. Like, always have to try and help your fellow compatriots out. Like, and you know, thinking about yourself when there's teammates around you that need what you need. It's jack.
If you have one individual who operates very well on his own, but is not a team player, he's of no use to us whatsoever, because at the end of the day, he's looking after number one, and this is where the expression Jack comes in. Jack the lad, I'm all right, Jack, and you look after number one, and everyone else can go to the devil. And that is wrong, and that's what we try to stamp out here.
Ball for Prince Charles. Down! Up! One for the memory of Princess Diana. Down! Both for Buckingham Palace. Stay down. Can you handle the pain?
Yes, sir!
Can you handle the pain?
Yes, sir!
Should we go and cut a tree down?
In Hampshire, the recruits have split up into teams. The girls' first job is to build a shelter.
Yeah, but we just got to get more in class now, and then...
Now we've got to get bits to go along with.
Nearby, Shane Neblett's boys' team are ahead of the girls and have finished their shelter by mid-afternoon.
We're going to set a few snares on that and hopefully we're going to get a bit of food, like some rabbits and stuff like that, but if we don't, we'll just have to starve then.
There is quite a lot of job opportunities in, like, Merseyside, but you've got to have good education, but I didn't get the grades necessary. I prefer to be doing stuff like this and I feel part of something, if you know what I mean.
Now, if I could have anything in the world,
I'd have a flake.
No.
I think I'm going into calorie. Get mode. Boom. Bye.
Things aren't going too well for the girls.
You... Oh! I'm going to scream, rather scream. Oh.
When you get from bed, I'm safe.
Their carefully constructed fire has collapsed.
No, but we've just started this now, because the two of them doing...
I'm sitting.
At Catterick, Peter Elliott just can't get enough of the army and has become one of the best members of the Guards platoon.
Since I was little, I've always wanted to be a soldier. When I was 13, I joined cadets, and then that boosted me even more to join the regular army. My mother was murdered, so, like, by my father, and that's why I was fostered, like, and he was in prison. Well, me and my brother were fostered, and that's why. And we're both doing, you know, we're doing both doing pretty well, like.
Elliot!
Today, he's being tested on his regimental knowledge.
Because my mother's gone, I talked to her just before a big test. Something that I really need help with, or just something to keep my mind focused. Sit in my bed and think about her, and, you know, maybe talk to her, and then say, you know, could you help me? And
what's the name of the Crony officer of the 1st Battalion of Scots Guards?
Lieutenant Colonel. Lieutenant Colonel.
It works like, you know, I think she's still there, like, so. And that's what helps me get through it, like, you know what I mean?
Stuart, sir.
Yeah, I've heard good things about you. What you need to do now is just gain in a bit of confidence. You know all the various things that there are to know. You just need a bit of detail, and you need a bit of confidence. When you come out here, it's your chance to show off to me and show me that you're good. Do you understand?
Aye, sir. Sir.
Elliot.
Yeah, I think he's a fairly, you know, happy, good lucky kind of guy and takes everything for what it is. You know, he maybe to some comes across as quite slow, but I think he's actually quite sharp. So he prides himself already on being a good soldier. And we were only saying the other day that actually I would take him in a platoon of the battalion as he is now.
The Guards are being psychologically prepared to unleash their aggression in a tough, close-quarter battle exercise.
Shut up! You all sound like a bunch of faggots. Nobody you couldn't scare of Tosser. A limp-wristed civvy. You couldn't scare him.
I want to see your fucking war face.
Now!
The Guards must dig deep to find their aggression.
If you have a look underneath logs.
Oh, you're joking now, let's get to it.
Okay, there's all sorts of nice things underneath logs. Okay. There's a wood lice there. Okay. Wood lice. Right, are related to prawns and the seafood, no problem.
I wouldn't eat meat for anything. Not at all.
A taste.
If you're starving, anything is on the menu.
Don't shut up.
What did it taste like again? Come on, do tell.
Fish?
You have fish. Gone. That's tastes like prawns, doesn't it?
Yeah. Honestly, it tastes of fish. Oh, they've put things low now.
Here.
That'll be right now.
What does it taste like? Fish. Prawn? Prawn, doesn't it?
Let's have a look.
Worms.
Worms
again.
Oh, God. Please, I'm trying to find
a worm. Come and have a look round for a worm, somebody.
I feel sick now. I'm trying to find the worms. I just don't like them. I think they're just horrible. They're too little and slimy. I'd never eat a worm.
Well then?
I wouldn't eat a babby. It's fairy what? And no one's a babby. I'd rather some worms. No go.
Right, worms. Right, as I said before, soak them in water for 24 hours, right? And that gets them all cleaned out. And then you get them like this, pull all the dirt out of them, like so, all the poo come out, yeah? Get all the dirt out of them, and then they're edible.
Oh,
yeah.
How are you doing?
Oh, what?
Okay.
It's a hard knife life for us. I mean,
it's a hard knife life for us. Says we eat, we'll build fires.
Right, you've got the idea anyway. Girls? Aye, aye, what are you two doing there? Just good friends, it's alright.
Have you got anything to
eat? I've got it in this bag. If you've got something wild, I'm willing to swap it for what's in my goodie
bag.
Can we
get a worm?
Yeah.
What?
And I'm terrified of worms.
I've got some.
I'll pick a worm up for you. Can we come back in 10 minutes?
If you find me something to eat, I'll let you put your hand in my lucky
what's
bag.
In
oh, all sorts of goodies. See? Oh.
Oh, they
didn't
did they have anything?
No.
Come on, let's see that. Come on.
Oh, what are you doing with that? Don't you be putting frogs in that tin?
The girls have only found poisonous mushrooms. They haven't eaten for 10 hours. In Catterick, the guards are being inspected by their company commander. They must prove that they can keep their living conditions clean and hygienic.
But he will come round and go through the rooms like a whirling dervish. The guys have probably been up most of the night, tidying me up.
Yeah. Good morning, sir. 22.
You are incorrectly dressed.
That's right, sir.
And your car is parked in the wrong place. I'll talk to you about it afterwards.
Sir.
In the second phase of training, the guardsmen are trusted to decorate and furnish their own bedrooms.
Make sure all the lights are on.
This is awful. None of it working. And the shelves are missing. No, not a good start. I don't know if I want to look any further. Will this take my weight?
I will, sir.
Now, if you're sitting here at night, why have you got the telly there? Did you make your bed this morning? Is that how you normally sleep?
Well, the colour on those sheets, they're not clean.
Show your bed made correctly.
Gold didn't show his bed made correctly.
Thank God the gold didn't show bed made correctly, sir.
Where's your webbing?
In my bed, sir.
Why is your webbing under your bed and everyone else's is above their head?
It's not easily.
Atkinson, who gave you these? Current regimental personalities.
It's St. Lily, sir.
Okay. Who is the colonel of your regiment? I'll give you a clue. Who is the colonel of your regiment?
Her Majesty the Queen.
No, that's his colonel in chief, isn't it? The colonel of the regiment? Who is it?
Sir William Rice.
Sir William Rice. Lieutenant General Sir William Rice. Sir. Wrong answer. This is supposed to be a room inspection, and some people quite clearly have not bothered. All I ask is to see a clean standard, a high standard that people live in. I don't expect bed blocks or anything like that. But having seen your accommodation now, it makes me think that maybe allowing them to have that much trust is wrong. I will re-inspect tomorrow morning at 7:30, and I expect to see all the beds made correctly.
On the survival course, it's 10 at night, and the girls are finding it hard to keep up their team spirit. It's now 16 hours since they've last eaten.
Right, without me bringing this blanket, no one will have it.
Okay, shut up
and just lie
moaning.
Straight.
Stop moaning.
Well, stop nicking the blanket.
I'm not nicking the blanket.
Moaning,
Annie.
Bye. Bye. Bye, it's my blanket.
Bye, Fame.
And my blanket underneath too.
You jab bitches, I'm cold. Why do you have to have your feet warm?
What do you mean, feet warm?
Why can't you put it the long way? You should have
well, jabbed. I thought it was the long way.
Words not.
There, we'll go to sleep then.
Well, congratulations, you fucking failed. You failed the company commander's room inspection because half of you could not be fucking bothered. Lockers, bags, fucking civvy lockers with no fucking clothes in. Fucking beds with one sheet on, beds with no fucking mattress covers. Fucking quilts without fucking quilt covers. Who the fucking hell do you think we are? Or who the fucking hell, more to the point, do you think you are? I shall fucking go through a few points for you. Here we fucking go, shall we? Start from the fucking top. Hunter, how the fuck you could sleep in that bed, I don't know. Elliot, you got show again. Shall I go on? You will re-show tomorrow morning to the company commander at 7:30, so do not expect any sleep tonight. You've embarrassed me. Now you fuckers stand by. I ain't even bothered.
just gives us all a kick up the arse, and if there is anyone that's been jacked and we don't know who it is sort of thing, we'll certainly be cleaning tonight because he won't want to be doing this again.
I knew we were going to fail anyway.
What?
Like, inside, like, had a feeling inside that we would fail. But you can't be good at, you can't, you know, you can't be good at everything.
It's 7:30 in the morning, and the company commander arrives for the re-inspection.
Another football.
Who's this?
They've all got long arms.
Can kiss each other.
One of the girls who likes me.
One of the girls.
Experts.
One of your experts. Where does she come from?
Liverpool, sir.
What have you been
here
for?
It's the better
one, sir. I take it she wasn't that upset.
She's probably heartbroken. She'll be lying in a gutter in Liverpool, man, injecting heroin into her veins, trying to find a better life or something like that. Very, very kinky. Very kinky sheets. You don't get the black satin ones. No. They're sold out of those. Smart tie, Elliot. Where'd you get that from?
In Penrith, sir.
Sorry?
In Penrith, sir.
In Penrith?
Aye, sir.
Is Penrith a bit of a fashion centre?
Oh, sort of, sir.
Sort of?
All right, sir.
It was much better. Being like that yesterday, it would have taken the same amount of time. We wouldn't be here today.
Sir?
See you at 9 o'clock on the drill square.
9 o'clock.
See that? That's my tie. Company commander liked that. Gonna wear it with pride.
In Hampshire, the recruits have survived their first night in the open.
Morning, ladies.
Bruising solid.
I really need to get a shower. He's so dirty. He's brushed my teeth and washed me. Just the one.
Okay, it's 7:30.
Right.
Stop feeling sorry for yourselves.
Get up and do something. Start looking around for food. It's daylight. Go looking around. There's edible stuff around here.
How's that going?
Compared to the girls, you know, these lot are, you know, way ahead. They're all sleeping together, you know, and they're working as a team. That's the main thing, you know. I'm afraid in the girls' team, three of them are doing nothing, and one's doing stuff. Yeah. Well done, boys.
Okay, well done, lads.
By lunchtime on the second day, the recruits still haven't found anything to eat.
You really make yourselves look stupid. You're all sitting down there, all wide-eyed, right, undernourished, OK? Feeling sorry for yourselves, but you're not doing nothing about it. If you was in a proper situation, what would you do? Just hope someone will come along and feed you? See you later.
Shane Neblett's team have decided to go hunting.
Hey!
There it is.
Can you see it?
Yeah.
Get up, Brago.
You're going to have to kill it before it goes in here.
Are you going to kill it? You can't kill that, man.
It's coming in. Yeah, it's coming in.
Just bite. It's ready to bite. Just watch what you've
done. Get it, sir.
Don't throw it. Just carefully do it. Go ahead.
Con, it's biting.
Right, don't close it up, bro.
T-shirt.
Got a snake. Aye.
Hey.
is light, isn't it?
Come back.
Oh, shut up. I'm not going to eat it.
Oh, God. Oh, God.
We're exchanging it.
No, we're just exchanging it, man.
The boys swapped the snake for army rations from Sergeant Paul's bag.
Okay. All right.
Arms left.
Billards, is that?
They are a protected creature. They are dangerous. Okay, so we'll let this one go. Come on, here you go, mate. Okay, go on, Anna.
And we found rotten. We had thistle and mint.
Found mushrooms.
Mushrooms, we couldn't eat
thistle.
We're one of the lucky ones. Like, they're starving. They've only had a few nettle teas and all that.
We've had creamed rice.
Mint and that.
Rub it in. Do you think that when you eat something now, it makes you more hungry?
No, it doesn't. Yeah, we've had potatoes and everything. We went robbing potatoes.
Shh. We'll lose Jack now.
Not us, because we've...
We hunted, we searched for them things.
Some of you haven't had food for something nearly 46 hours, so you're feeling a bit hungry, right? They're now going to give you some food. But the only thing is, you're going to get it nature's way, and you're going to have to prepare it yourself. Oh, I'm terrible. There's a number of ways you can get the feathers off a chicken. So all you currently do is pluck the chicken, not the other thing, pluck it. It's put it this way, all of it...
As a vegetarian, okay? Fern Woodacre finds it difficult to watch.
These chickens are the type of ones you get in the shops, in the supermarkets, right, because it's a battery hen. So when you go to a shop, this is what it looks like before it ended up in a nice little plastic bag in Tesco.
Oh, wow.
Sharpest stuff you got, okay? What you got to look for is the bum hole.
Keep it away from me.
Get a brick or something and just sit there and hold it.
Oh my God.
The recruits are judged on their ability to work as a team. They cannot jack on their mates.
You don't want to do it, man. You don't want to do it. I'll do it instead.
What's it like now?
Wow, where's the water spill?
Horrible. Horrible.
You've
got to
do it though.
I'm going to do the chicken shells and I'll do the rabbit. Well, I'm doing the chicken shells and the rabbit.
I'm not doing the rabbit.
No,
we've gone back to the chapel centre. We've got yours for us.
I'm dead strongly against it. Like, I'm into watching that. Yeah. As much as I could only watch bits of it. I would kill for my country. Because that's my job. You know, I wouldn't kill them for no reason, but if they were running towards me with an axe or something, then I would. But little animals like that, it's just, you know.
No, you don't tear it like that, just keep...
Just harmless.
No, you want to bring it up to the middle, OK? I'll hold it there. You cut. OK?
Yeah, I don't need the scissors.
Woodacre. She played on the vegetarian bit, I think. And then she got so bad and that the other girls cooked her potatoes for her, which I thought was outrageous.
Am I a good cook or am I a good cook?
She's a vegetarian. That's her, you know, that's her prerogative, and I've got nothing against that. But when she plays it off where she's got the others cooking her food for her and sitting there doing nothing, don't think it's fair on the others.
It's nearly the end of the exercise, and time at last for food. In Catterick, the guards' close quarter battle exercise begins.
Take out your bayonets and fix your bayonets to the rifles.
It's Peter Elliott's turn to prove himself on the battlefield.
Come on, Elliot. They're laughing at you. They're laughing.
Bayonet warfare is probably the nastiest warfare you can possibly do. It's CQB, it's close quarter battle, and it is thoroughly unpleasant. And so we have to try and prepare them for what we hope will never happen. Excuse me. If I was the enemy and some of these chaps are coming screaming through at me, I might think about legging it pretty quickly.
Come on, let's go, let's go. Go! Come on, let's shoot at you. Come on! Kill him! More!
Even though he has snapped his bayonet, Elliot keeps going.
Come on! Stop there. Stop. Take your brain off. Dress it up.
I saw my bayonet. It was bent. It snapped in the second dummy.
You snap your bayonet, you're doing it properly. Away you go. Well done.
I just thought about people who I hate in my life. And if your bayonet snaps, just keep going on. So I never joined the army to be a choir boy. So, you know, I joined infantry to kill, like, and not to kill straight away, like.
And even though he had that much of a bayonet left, he kept going. That's what it takes. That is pure aggression. You end with that, your life on the line, gentlemen. You can still kill somebody with that. It may take a little bit longer, but that's what it is. That is aggression.
Some of the guards have been surprised by their reactions to the exercise.
I don't know. I don't know what I expected, to be honest, but that was pumping. That was it's hard to explain, actually. Because I never thought I'd... Because I'm not an aggressive person, but that actually made me think about, oh, you bastard, you know, that actually made me quite aggressive, that, but... I didn't know I had that in me at all. I really didn't. He was constantly thinking, but he was like, he wasn't on the serve sort of thing. All you wanted to do was just destroy that dummy. And anyone that sort of, well, literally got in his ears really pissed you off. You just wanted to destroy him. It was madness.
Bring your rifle and your helmet in and your bayonet. Okay? Quick as you can.
Sir.
Get in.
I'll let your mic run.
It's all right. Can I go in, Tim?
All right.
I've sworn an allegiance to the Queen, yeah, I've got to protect her. But I've also... The younger generation's behind us. You know what I mean? I don't want a nasty world. I would die for my country. No, I hope it didn't come to that. I'll try my best not to.
I bounced across a poppy field. I saw the queen as she raised your shield. Blood streamed down with the sun behind its back. We're all soldiers, should we be soldiers too? Fighting and falling like soldiers, good.